So hi, my name's Virgil. I work in special projects for the foundation, and it's kind of a grab bag of stuff, and there's a lot of variety. I used to do research, but now I do mostly management, and I'll be kind of showing you kind of a suite of sort of interesting things that the special project team has been working on. So there's a few follow-ups from last year. So this is an old thing, but a lot of people still don't know about it yet. So but some people ask, oh, where do I get these cool Ethereum shirts? You can get them right now. They're at swag.ethereum.org, and you can get all kinds of stuff, like these lovely shirts you see here. You can pay in either ETH or Doge. Also from last year, I talked about Ether being more halal than Bitcoin. There is a follow-up to that this year. That is the last day of the conference at 1310. The talk, Is Ethereum Compatible with Islamic Finance? By, frankly, one of the foremost Sharia scholars in the entire world here at Devcon. It is a little weird, I know. But, we're happy to have him. So this is the stuff. So now we're on for this year. So there's a couple of new things I want to share with y'all. So there's an analogy that I used to use, saying that Ethereum is the world computer. I no longer say that. I think instead, Ethereum is the arena where we can play the positive sum games that we could not play before. So for example, take the prisoner's dilemma. This is a classic game that we're all familiar with, and it's a classic non-cooperative game, and you always defect. In Ethereum, this becomes a positive-sum game, because before you go do your criminal thing, you can say, oh, I'm going to put on a deposit of, say, $1 billion, saying, if I defect, this money just gets burned. All right, this is fundamentally new, because you're able to move the Nash equilibriums. And this seems to be like a fundamentally new thing in Ethereum. So like one thing I think would be really interesting to do is to go through sort of a classic game theory textbook and find like all the games that are typically non-cooperative. And then say, if you then arm the agents with Ethereum, how many of them now become cooperative games? And this could be big. So you're looking for, there's probably more things like this. So in short, I think this is the way to think about what Ethereum is good for. All right, so here's another thing to think about. So I'd say the first killer app for Ethereum was just sending integers to each other, just sending money. The third one was, unfortunately, probably the ICO. But the third, I think, could be parametric insurance. Now, though you have probably not heard of parametric insurance, so this is insurance, it's like an if-then, like if X happens, you get money, and there's no filing process, no nothing. So a lot of disaster insurance works this way, but usually like cities will get this, like, if there's an earthquake, we just automatically get paid out. So so Ethereum is actually bringing this to everyday people. So there's one very nice example I like is in Puerto Rico. So in case you don't know, Puerto Rico's had some trouble with hurricanes lately. And so you can actually now buy hurricane insurance. Puerto Rico can now buy hurricane insurance such that if the National Weather Service says wind speeds exceed some integer in your zip code, you just get paid in ether within a day, and it's just done. Now, this is cool. And like you probably use for other things. You probably use for like flood insurance, like monsoon insurance, all kinds of stuff. Anyway, this is new stuff. All right, infrastructure. So we are getting a new grants front end. So you can check it out now. It's using a service called Guana. We just finished the beta run, so your grants will be becoming more transparent. We have a new wiki system. So you've probably seen the Bitcoin It wiki. We got a new one. So we got a thing we think is better called Ethereum.wiki. It is already better than the Bitcoin one, and it's getting even better still. So if you want a new wiki to play with, please come play with that. I have this new toy called ETH-ETC. So this was originally being done inside the foundation. It has now been spun out to a group called Comba. And so basically it is physical ether. I don't got anything, but I can give them out to you here. Basically the gist that it's like a gift card, and you scratch off the back to reveal the private key and you get money. And you also put crypto kitties on them, stuff like that. So this is so you can like physically send assets. There is some new stuff with cross-chain compatibility with Ethereum Classic. So there's this new project called the Peace Bridge. And so in short, so the goal here is to have a plasma chain, which you've all heard of, but we have a thing with dual roots. We have one root on the ETC chain, one root on the ETH chain, and they can both put deposits into the same chain. And this provides a neutral ground where you can do atomic swaps. And additionally, transactions from each chain become visible on the other. This is neat, and so this is a new thing we're playing with. Speaking of Ethereum Classic, we just gave them a grant. We gave them a grant of $150,000. And you know what? You can read about why. In short, some of their engineering is actually pretty decent. And you know what? And we get to like show how benevolent we are. So if you want to, you can read all about that. The Twitter is great about that. All right, so I'm going to show you some cool apps now. So I got this new thing. So this is called the Wolfram Oracle. So you may have heard something called Wolfram Alpha. This is like you can type it in, you can answer questions. So there's this new you can now, so these things they turn into a language. So you can like when you ask like, you know, is X prime, you say like is 5 prime right here. It turns it into a question here, so it turns into a code. You can actually type this code directly, and you can get answers. So one neat thing about this is that you can put in all kinds of stuff. You can ask, you know, like what is the murder rate in the United States? You can ask, what is the price of gold on this date? Oh, I didn't like that one. All right, you can invert a matrix. So in short, so this is a Wolfram Alpha Oracle on Ethereum, and you can just ask it all kinds of stuff. And so there's a service called rhombus.network that is currently doing that. So if you want to offload mass amounts of computation, like saying is a number prime, or interpolate a polynomial, or you know, all kinds of things, you can now do that. Now, there's another cool thing coming out. So you've all probably heard of SGX. So there's a new thing coming out from Intel where you can turn the SGX into a hardware wallet. This is neat because it means that every Windows PC in the world is now a hardware wallet. And so you can now trust, you don't have to worry about getting owned anymore. So you can now keep Ether on your own desktop without having to fumble around with a hardware wallet. So that's a new thing coming out shortly. So this is the future. So there's a new project we're working on called Never Slash. So this the real problem with proof of stake is if you get owned, someone can cause your assets to get slashed, meaning like they get destroyed. This Never Slash thing, it is a Raspberry Pi that sits between you and a hardware wallet. So if you're having a staking machine using Casper, you have a hardware wallet that you stake on, and you have your PC that's running the Ethereum node. You put this Raspberry Pi as a USB between your staking machine and your hardware wallet. And it looks at all of the votes going through. And if it ever sees a vote that would cause you to get slashed, it just refuses to propagate it. Now, this is really nice, because as long as you have this thing plugged in, you don't get slashed, period. I guess one could physically come by, but no, so basically, even if you get owned, you still don't get slashed. And I think this is one of the coolest things out there. So there's one more project. So I call it the voluntary backdoors. So this is still upcoming. So the idea is, this part is a graceful fallback to the traditional legal system. So you've probably heard of plasma, and you've probably heard of, so there's also substrate, which is the new thing that was just announced at Web3. Basically, it allows you to create a brand new blockchain with your own defined rules. So the idea is to create a new blockchain for every country on Earth. And the rules are exactly the same as traditional Ethereum, except it is backdoored by that government. So the idea would be like, say if I'm a Singaporean and you're like, oh, I don't know, you're an American, but for whatever reason, we just love French courts. And so instead of doing our contract on the big Ethereum chain, we can do it on the .fr plasma chain, such that if anything terrible ever happened, we could then go to a French court and say, you got a key back there that would really help us out. So please use it. Now the keys you can use, you can piggyback on the keys from the DNSSEC infrastructure. So, and that's how you get a key for every government. So the government doesn't even have to give you permission to do this. You can just rope them in. So, because if there's like an example, because like for every country, say .cz for a Czech Republic, there is a key that says, is foo.cz, a legit name? And you can just use that exact same key. So, yeah, that's a cool thing for voluntary backdoors. And the reason you'd want to do that is that if there's any country on earth that you would trust to have a more reliable legal system than your own coding abilities, you can now use this. And it's also neat because it kind of makes country legal systems kind of compete with each other, for your contracts, and that's also kind of fun. So this is like purely just a side one, but for the Americans in the room, Puerto Rico is really developing into a real crypto hub, and you can pay 0% capital gains. So if you're into that and you're an American, recommend it. It's crypto.pr if you're into that. All right, that's kind of the. Am I done? Well, all right, I think I'm done. So this is basically the gist. So this is things that I'm looking for. I'm looking for someone that can captain the Ethereum.wiki. I'm looking for someone that can curate the ETH research message board. And if you have someone that can do the, if you have students in embedded systems and Raspberry Pis, I'd like to talk to you. And also the Ethereum Foundation is hiring for both DevOps and fundamental research. So if you're interested in that, come chat with me. If you also know how to code Viper, come chat with me as well. So here's all the URLs that we presented here because people like to look at the URLs. Yeah, I don't know. This is usually a thing where people like to take pictures, photos of that. So this is usually where people have a lot of questions. All right, so that we can just do questions now. Oh, sure.
Hey, hi Virgil. Can you talk a little bit? Hi. Can you talk a little bit about the key reconstruction or custody for that backdooring solution and the potential of bringing nation-state politics to Ethereum blockchains?
No. I mean. Yeah, no. I think the hope would just be that if you want to have the option to be able to be bailed out, you can now have that option. I would anticipate probably most people would probably not want to. Most of my friends would probably not want that. But I've met people that are really into it. Like the Singaporeans, they're all about trusting their government, and like they'd be like, and they're much more scared of them making errors than they are of their government being shifty.